Dear ladies and gentlemen, dear committee, acute kidney injury and chronic kidney disease represent worldwide problem. More than 10% of population suffers from kidney disease. An assessment of plasma creatinine and urea is commonly used approach for the evaluation of kidney functions. When the kidney function is impaired, kidneys are not able to excrete waste products such as creatinine and urea, which leads to their accumulation in blood. These accumulated waste products are cytotoxic for the organism. Thus, patients with kidney disease have to undergo hemodialysis that filter these waste products from their bodies. This hemodialysis is also associated with frequent stays in hemodialysis units and repeated blood collections to monitor kidney disease. Another type of dialysis is peritoneal dialysis that could be performed even at home. Nevertheless, patients have to visit the doctor due to repeated blood collection for monitoring of kidney disease. It would be beneficial if alternative body fluid to blood was used for the assessment of kidney function. The increased concentration of plasma creatinine and urea creates concentration gradient for the diffusion from blood to saliva. The saliva could represent non-invasive replacement of commonly used blood collection. Using the saliva in clinical practice would eliminate problems associated with repeated blood collections. Patient could collect the saliva even at home and send it to the laboratory without stress or pain, or could use home monitoring dipsticks like this. However, high variability prevents wider clinical use of saliva in practice. And only animal experiment could detect and uncover the underlying factors. Using different animal models, we firstly described detailed dynamics of changes of salivary creatinine and urea during the development of various types of kidney disease. We found out that salivary creatinine and urea increase during the development of kidney disease, and they copy their plasma concentration. This determination of dynamics of changes of salivary creatinine and urea allows better understanding and better monitoring of other factors that could influence salivary markers of kidney function, which help with the introducing the saliva into the clinical practice. And this is how I would like to break the wall. Thank you for your attention.